Let's get it! Let's get a kick it!
You feel like...
Good morning, guys. I slept really good last night. Yeah, it's about 9 a.m. First things first is coffee, but my coffee machine broke, so we're just gonna go pick some up. I just pulled up. I'm at Starbucks. Guys, it is 100 degrees out. 9:36. Anyways, we're at Starbucks. I'm just gonna get a black coffee because I have all my stuff at home that I can put in it. So we're keeping it boring this morning.
Thank you for choosing Starbucks. What can I get started for you?
Hi, can I just get a large pike?
Large pike?
Yeah.
286 at the window.
Thank you. We got the goods. So I've got class at 12:15, so I'm just gonna sit here, drink my coffee, and then I will see you guys around lunchtime, and we'll make, I don't know what I'm gonna make, but it's gonna be good. Okay, so I just showered, I finished my only class that I had today, and I'm starving, so let's go cook some lunch. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna make is just like a little veggie scramble. So you'll need some eggs, and then I just honestly any sort of like vegetable mix, but I like this one because it's red, yellow, and green bell peppers, and then some spinach. So we're just gonna throw these in a pan together and mix them all up basically. So I just put a little bit of canola oil in the pan. I'm gonna let it heat up. Don't judge my pan. I know it's burnt and crusty, but I'm the only one eating out of it, so I don't really care. I just have it on a medium heat, and we're gonna put our veggies in. Honestly, I'm gonna just put the rest of the bag.
Yeah!
Shake them around a little bit, and let those heat up, kind of defrost. So while those are kind of like defrosting on the stove, I'm gonna make, obviously, avocado toast. So let me get my bread. I've got my Ezekiel bread. I love this stuff. And like I said before, this is not necessarily gluten-free. Actually, maybe it is. It says flourless. I think that makes something gluten-free, correct? I'm just gonna say it. It is gluten-free, I think. Also, a quick tip. I always put my bread in the freezer because it keeps it fresh for longer, especially gluten-free bread. I don't know why, but that stuff molds so quick. Like, it probably lasts a week. I don't know the science behind it, but whenever I get gluten-free bread, I always have to freeze it because it molds within like days. So put this in the freezer, and then I'll just stick this in the microwave for like 30 seconds. That's really basically it. That's all you gotta do. Ooh. Okay, I think I went a little too long because she's smoking. And then another hack, if you're in college and you were broke and don't have a toaster, just use your oven. So one of my friends actually showed me this, but this is basically what I do. So you're just gonna put your oven on broil on high. And so now that that's on, I am just gonna stick my bread in the oven and let it broil. I don't know why that looks so sad.
what you say.
So now that these are definitely de-thawed, I'm gonna add a little bit of spinach. And I'm gonna be real with you guys. Spinach genuinely tastes like nothing, and I just put it in a lot of my recipes because it's good to add more greens. So just add as much as you want, and you ain't gonna taste it, but your body will appreciate it. Yeah, so we'll let those cook for a little bit, and do not forget about your toast that is broiling, okay? Because
what you said.
Them boys are on now, and that thing is gonna get hot, and I've forgotten about it many times. I'm just gonna keep tossing this around, and once the spinach gets kind of wilty, because I don't want it to be non-existent, you know, when you cook spinach too much and you basically don't have anything. I turn the heat down just a little bit and let those cook, and then we're gonna crack two eggs right in there.
Look at all those chickens.
We got the eggs in there, so I'm just gonna kind of scramble all of this together. Okay, so I'm gonna sprinkle on a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. Actually, not a little bit, I love pepper, so I always do a lot. Then I'm just gonna kind of scramble those together. Also, this pan is really giving me a run for my money. Every time I cook on it, all of my stuff just sticks. Yeah. Anyway, oh, my bread. Okay.
What you say?
Okay, actually, that looks perfect. So be very careful, but you're gonna flip your bread. So, and then I'll come back to you guys when this is cooked all the way. We made a big deal about not burning your toast, and what did I do? Okay, so the eggs are looking good. I'm gonna turn the heat off, and I'm just gonna kind of let them cook for a little bit just with no heat. And look at this pan, bro. Everything sticks to it, but it's all right. There's worse things going on in the world. Okay, so I got the toast and my avocado. And do not discard avocados like this, because I'm gonna show you how you can still use it. Just slice that little top part off.
Don't cut yourself like I do.
Then get a fork.
Is you blind?
Okay, this is the fork, avocado. I'm gonna take this and scoop it on the toast. Okay. And then I'm just gonna spread it with the fork.
Spreading the avocado. Spreading the avocado.
So I'm just gonna add some salt and pepper to my toast. A lot of pepper, like I said before. I love pepper. It's the goods. Okay, so. I'm trying to make this pretty because I'm gonna have to take a picture of it. So we'll see how this goes. Bro, I need to invest in a nonstick pan though. This is not it. Look at this finished product. It looks so good. So the last thing I'm gonna add is just some nutritional yeast to the eggs. I was gonna say it kind of tastes like cheese, but it really doesn't. But if you just like put your mind to it and make yourself think it tastes like cheese, it will. Okay, I'm out of cups, so we're gonna drink right out of the jug. It's time for a taste test. Let me see if I can get all of it in there. It's good. But I knew it was good because I make this all the time. Okay. Let's try the toast. A little burnt, but still good. All right. I'm gonna finish this and I'll see you guys for our next meal, snack. I don't know, we'll just see where this day takes us. All right, let me put you guys on to something. Right, so we're gonna take big old chicken and put that there. And I did it. So good.
Okay, love, I'm eating ice cream!
Guess what I mean? Popcorn! All right, ladies and gents, it's dinner time. I'm hungry and I'm ready to make. This. You don't gotta put a lot of work into it. So let's get going.
So what you're gonna wanna do first is heat up a pan and just put some water in it. And then I would say put it on like medium heat on the stove.
So then I cut the little packet open and you gotta fish out the noodles in the back and the sauce. So now I just gotta just get handsy with this thing. Oh, I'm feeling it, I'm feeling it. So these are the noodles. They're actually really good, but right now, and then the sauce packet. The rest of this is just gonna go in a pan and we're just gonna heat it up on medium heat with some oil.
Boys, don't oil, bruh. Okay, it's gonna be a lot. I'm gonna just kinda jab at it for a bit there. What is this? Sorry, this was not in the last kit. What is it? Okay, we're not eating this.
I'm gonna cut these noodles open. It says to put them in like the warm water and just loosen them up. And I'm sorry if I'm giving really bad directions, but if you buy one of these kits, it's got the directions in the back, so you'll be taken care of. It's all right. And you're just gonna take this thing. And put it in your pot.
Huh? And just kind of let that thing sit in there for a while. Okay, so these guys are looking good. And also our noodles, I was poking around in them a little bit and they're kind of breaking up. Taste. Bruh. Okay. So I just drained the noodles and this is what they look like. So you're literally just gonna. And then, okay, we're gonna mix these. I'm getting excited because we're about to add the sauce.
Kind of just toss these around really quick.
Bruh, you're getting feisty up in there, chill. And then give it one final little toss. Sauce that you just put in there. Okay, so I'm just gonna toss this. I'm not gonna lie, I can finish this whole thing. I'm not gonna act like I won't. Okay, and this is dinner. Like, that was so friggin' easy.
Let's give this bad boy a try. I gotta get all the veggies, all the noodles.
We got a solid bite right there.
Hot. Yeah, it's really good. Okay, so I was just sitting here and I realized I didn't even tell you guys like what is in this. So it's got the soba noodles, but it's also got broccoli, bok choy, onions, and snow peas. And then that's just like a soy sauce that comes with the thing. So yeah, enjoy.